This is the introduction to exercise 9C on using set notation, page 580 of your textbook. The question we're answering today is, how do we properly write probability in mathematical notation? Because unfortunately, you can't just write the probability of blah, blah, blah happening is this, right? You have to write in mathematical notation to A, make it consistent amongst your peers, and also B, make it more efficient, right? Save time. So there are a couple of definitions I'd like to go over. First thing, sample space, you guys already know. I've included the definitions for these. If you feel like you've just taken those definitions out in the previous one, you're welcome to not write that down, of course. So sample space, as you mentioned, is all possible outcomes, or something we might call the universal set, and is symbolized by S, omega, which is that, as Jaden called it, Q-looking thing, the capital U, or the big U, and then a squiggly line, right? I don't know what that one's called either, but the point is, you don't need to know what it does, where else it's used, whatever it is. All you need to know is, if you see that, it means sample space. That's all. Okay. The second one here is subset. This one should be new. The subset of something is represented by this sideways looking U, right? And it just means when all elements of one group fit into another. So for example, if all of the numbers in group A fit into group B, you'd say that A is a subset of group B, right? It's when all of them fit into another one. And when I say elements, I want you to think of, for example, the numbers on a dice, or the heads or tails, or whatever it is. Complement, we talked about that one already, which is just represented by the dash. So A dash means what's not in A. An element, as I mentioned. Now, this one is a weird-looking symbol, but that sideways, weird curved-looking E just means an element of. So if I said 5 is an element of A, that just means that in group A, there is a 5. That's it. Gone through 4 definitions. Any questions so far? Okay, for the second section over there, you can see null or empty set, right? That symbol there with the 0 crossed out means that's an empty set. In terms of, for example, there's nothing in it, right? It might be there's no numbers in it. There's no colors or no whatever it is. You just write that symbol there. Basically meaning if your sample space is written, there's nothing in it. Your cardinal number is just the number of elements in it, right? Not to be mistaken with what the sample space is. It'd be how many things are in the sample space. And we'll go through an example in a moment. Finally, this is the one that's probably the most important takeaway from this lesson. Union versus intersection. Have you guys done this before? No. Yeah? If you see union, which is symbolized by the U, it means A or B in the circumstance. Or being the keyword. If you see or, it means union. And it's very important because when we do year 11 methods, year 12 methods, that comes up as well. Right? So or means union. If you see intersection, then it means and. So where those overlap in your Venn diagram would be where those two circles overlap. So intersection is and. It means it has to have characteristics of both. Any questions? Great. It's great having the water trickle down in the background. All right, so let's go through a couple of questions and we'll jump right to it. Looks like a lot. It shouldn't take us too long. A number is chosen from the set of positive integers between 1 and 8 inclusive. Inclusive meaning that...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Thank you very much. We're including 8 as well. A is a set of odd numbers between 1 and 8, and B is a set of prime numbers between 1 and 8 inclusive. List the sets. So the sample space. Sample space is pretty straightforward. It's just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm assuming you guys are okay with me not writing that. Just don't forget your squiggly brackets. Now we list the set of A. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write A equals, and same thing with the squiggly brackets. So all the numbers in A is a set of odd numbers between 1 and 8. Of course, we know that to be 1, 3, 5, and 7. B is the set of prime numbers between 1 and 8. Do we include 1? Is 1 a prime number? No, it's not. So we start with 2. And then we go 3, 5, and 7. Any qualms with that? I like how it's gotten to the point where I can just throw out a random word like that and no one questions it anymore. Quorn. Okay. Question B. Draw a Venn diagram. Okay. So we're going to have our two sets, right? So I'm going to draw my Venn diagram on the bottom, so just so I have a little bit more space. I'm going to label this one A and this one B. Now, the numbers from 1 to 8 need to fit into this rectangle, right? So we're no longer looking at it just in the sense of how many, but what numbers as well. So, of course, if we're saying drawing a Venn diagram, we're going to place the cardinal number into each appropriate region, the cardinal number. So, and definition-wise, you could also write down each individual number that's inside each region, but let's focus on the cardinal number. So the cardinal number, referring back to here, is the number of elements. So how many numbers are not in either set? So there's four, there is six, and there's eight. So I'm going to write a three here to show that's in neither A or B. How many numbers are in both? Well, there's three, five and seven. So I'm going to write a three in the overlap. How many numbers are in just A, but not B? Well, that'd just be one. And of course, one here as well. And I'm going to double check. How many numbers do I have? One plus three plus one plus three gives me eight. I've not missed anything. Perfect. Now, listing these sets. Now, A, what does this symbol mean again?
Oh.
Is it union or intersection?
And.
And, right, intersection, good. For me, I remember as union has to be a U, right? And the not union is intersection, which is this, all right? So the intersection between those two, we're saying when is it A and B? I would write 3, 5, 7. Why am I not just writing three? Because there's a three there, right? Shouldn't I just write three?
Because they're listed now.
I'm going to list the sets. That's what the question asks. The set, not the number of, right? The set. A union B, which means I'm looking for. What does it union mean again? What's the. Thank you very much. It means or. So we're saying what numbers are in either A or B, which gives me an answer of 1, 2, 3, 5, and 7. Is that a bit small for you guys up the back? No? Okay. Thank you. A dash. Now, A dash, I think you guys already know this one from the last one. What does the dash mean again?
Not
Thank you very much. Complement, which means not A as well. So, circumstances say that not A would be given by 2, 4, 6, and 8. Or in other words, well, the even numbers, because A was the odd numbers. And B only, is it going to be 2, 3, 5, 7? Is that B only? Or is that B? What's B only?
One.
Two, thank you very much. Or one number. In this circumstance, because we're writing a list, we write two. Great. N, A, what does the N mean again?
Number.
The number of, or the cardinal number, right? So the number of numbers in this circumstance for A is just going to be four, because there are four numbers here. The probability of A will be 4/8. And we're getting that because there is a total of four. Sorry, there is a four numbers in A out of a total of eight, which gives me a half. The number of numbers in A intersection B, do I have to go do a bunch of math for this one? What's the number? It's just three because it's overlapping. Good. And the probability of A intersecting B, we know now, is 3/8. Pretty straightforward. Yes. Yes, no. Well, regardless, I want to ask us to do some practice. So, exercise 90, questions of page 583. Thank you.